joined by TJ Finley. Our first question will be from Jordan Hill.
TJ, just what's the whirlwind been like the last couple days since you, ended up Bo was hurt, was going to be out, and just how has preparation this week been getting ready for South Carolina?
Well, it's always bad news when the starter goes down. But as we know at college football, a lot of injuries take place, and the backup guys have to be prepared to play. I've been preparing like a starter since day one, since I've got here. Me and Bo have a lot of good conversations about what's going on with the game plan and things of that nature. So, with him going down is an unfortunate situation. But, like I said, I've been preparing, week in and week out to be the starter. So when my opportunity came, I wouldn't miss it.
All right, next question, Bennett Durando.
Can you repeat? What's the question? Like how to?
Yeah, I want to ask, when sort of every week is a backup and you're sort of preparing like a starter, like you said, but not ending up in the games, how do you sort of stay mentally sharp in terms of being prepared to go in at any point?
Well, I know for a fact that, me preparing to be the starter each week is only getting me better. As a player, as a teammate, as a leader on this team, it's only allowing my guys to see the best side of me on and off the field. And my ultimate goal is to make it to the NFL. So whether I'm the backup or the starter, I have to prepare to be able to play and go in at any given time. So my mindset has been, since I've been here, prepare every day like I'm the starter, because, a lot of guys look up to the quarterback position. A lot of guys look at the quarterback as the focal point of the team, outside of the head coach. So as long as those guys see me doing my job and getting the job done as a backup, then when my time comes as a starter, it's easy for them to believe in me and trust that I'll get the job done.
Next one for Jason Caldwell.
Yeah, man. Me and my family talked about that Monday morning, that my first start at LSU was also against South Carolina. So it's just a blessing. I don't believe in coincidences. I think God has a plan for everything. God has a purpose for everything. So I'm just going to go out there and do what I did last year and just, play composed and be consistent and do my job, get the job done. No, not really. I wouldn't say it like that, because like you said, this is a totally different team, a totally different coaching staff and different schemes that they brought from different places. So my performance last year has nothing to do with this year, but I am preparing this week, with my team, and we're preparing to the best of our ability to go out there and do what we've practiced and get the job done.
All right, next question, Dubois Wilborn.
Good, how are you?
Man, I'm blessed, man. I can't explain that. How did you
say? Good.
With you, who's been the most interesting person that you've heard from over the last few days? Somebody who maybe you hadn't heard from in a while, just kind of reached out to you. Who's some of those people? Thank you, man.
I would say has to be Cam Newton. Right before he got signed, I think it was a week before he got signed, he called me and we went through a devotional together. I don't want to say the things that he told me, but it was a lot of stuff talked about, which I'm low-key getting emotional right now about it, but because the things we talked about came to fruition. He's one of the most inspirational people in my life. I've looked up to him since I was a little kid, and to say that he's reaching out to me, as a little brother and helping me throughout my path of college football, it means a lot to me. And I pray me and him continue to have those conversations and things like that. So I would say Cam is one of the most, inspirational people I've talked to recently, that's helped me out with my walk in college.
Did you have his number already, or did you know it was him when he called? Because sometimes you know, you get somebody famous calling you.
Right.
Yeah,
so I met him at in a Pipeline 707 my senior year in high school, going into college, and I think I was already taller than him, so I stood out above everybody, and he came and introduced himself to me. At the time, I was committed to LSU, so we had no connection, you know, and then ever since then, we've kind of been here and there on Instagram and things like that. But the time he did call me was after the Georgia State game. I did not have his number. And when he called me, it was an Atlanta number. So, you know, I'm pretty close to Atlanta and things like that. So I answered and picked up, and it was him. And I was just like, wow, like, you know, I can't believe this happening. I guess he got my number from his little brother, because me and his little brother, Kalen, talk a lot and things like that. So, yeah, when he called me, I did not know it was him.
Next question, Tom Green.
Yeah, those guys are special. Our whole receiver room is special, and I don't think you guys have been able to see that yet as a group. You know, those two guys stood out last game, and that's just a tad bit of what they can do. You know, those guys are only going to get better from here. You know, they've been working their butts off. Coach Keys has done an amazing job getting them guys prepared week in and week out. You know, and it does give me a lot of confidence knowing that they are able to get the job done, you know, and they're able to do what we've been coaching them to do. All week, and translate that over to the game. So those guys are coming along. The receiver core, Shed is doing an amazing job getting them guys, being the leader of that group. Demetrius Robertson is doing a great job, continuing to be a leader and a vocal leader and things like that. So those guys are working together. Those guys are brothers. Those guys help each other. You know, when they come to the sideline, they're communicating with each other what they're seeing out there and things that they can do to get open for the quarterback and things like that. So the confidence I have in them guys has only gone up.
Next question, Jeff Spiegel.
DJ, how beneficial was that experience at LSU, and also coming through in a big situation against Georgia State, how much would that help you going into this big opportunity?
Yeah, the experience I had last year was a focal point in my life. You know, it allowed me to really grasp the things that I was getting from LSU, like the lessons I had learned based on my performances and things like that. So the things that I'm focusing on this year that didn't happen last year was just consistency. And I talked about that when I was in the transfer portal. I got a lot of interviews from different people. So the main thing I'm focusing on is consistency. I don't have to do anything special. All I have to do is go out there and do my job, simple as that, and everything will take care of itself.
Next question, Nathan King.
Hey, TJ, I know when you did transfer from LSU and you arrived here, there were some guys who kind of met you at the front door on your first day. Who were those guys that greeted your family? And I guess how important have your relationships been in making this transition from one program to another with your new teammates?
Yeah, so I'm going to give you a funny story. So Tank Bigsby, which is he's a clown. Everybody knows that. We were actually in Fort Lauderdale together, not together, but I was in Fort Lauderdale on a vacation with my girlfriend, and Tank was up out there working out. So when I got in the portal, Tank was the first person to call me. Tank called me and was like, you know, I really want you to come to Auburn. You know, we have Bo Nix, but when he graduates, when he leaves, we need another guy. And I was like, okay, you know, blah, blah, blah. So I went over to his Airbnb spot, and he called Coach Bobo. And Coach Bobo was on the phone and telling me all these good things and stuff like that. So immediately right then and there, me and Tank, you know, had reconnected because we knew each other by 707 and camps and things like that. So he was one of the first guys to reach out to me. Kobe Hudson was a guy that reached out to me while I was still at LSU trying to get me to come over here. And then when I got here, Kobe Wooden was a big part of me moving in and me getting settled and me getting comfortable with everybody and things like that. So those three guys, I would say, are the top three guys that, you know, really helped me, you know, get comfortable here and find my place here.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Next question, Justin Hokinson.
Hey, TJ. How would you describe kind of your comfort level maybe this week? Were you getting all the first
first off, I want to say I like your setup. Your setup is pretty cool back there. I like it. But to answer your question, no, I don't think it's a big difference. Like I said earlier, I've been preparing to be the starter, you know, since week one. And I take a lot of mental reps. You know, the backup don't get a lot of reps. And just like Grant Loy is doing now, he's taking a lot of mental reps, even though he's not getting the physical reps. The mental reps is really what matters. You know, not now. Granted, if I was to get in, you know, unfortunate situation, I was to get in earlier this year, you know, some plays wouldn't look as good as they would if I got the physical rep. But at the same time, the mental rep, you know, is what counts. So I wouldn't say it's going to make a drastic change, but getting those physical reps, you know, does matter as well.
Next question, Mark Murphy.
That's going to be very important. You know, we need to dominate the line of scrimmage both in the run game and the passing game. And when you're the most physical team, the outcome of success is very high. The rate of success is very high. So, you know, once we get the run game going, and I believe we will, those guys up front has been working their butts off. Coach Friend is doing an amazing job with the run game and things like that, the game plan to get these guys in the best situation to be successful. So. I do believe you'll see a different run attack this week. You know, I just can't wait to display that for you guys.
Thanks.
All right, we got time for two more. We'll go next to Brian Matthews.
Hi, TJ. How much support have you gotten from your teammates on and off the field this week so far, and what has it meant to you?
I've gotten a lot of support. You know, those guys, you know, like I said, I've been doing my best to be a leader since I've gotten here. I know I'm young, I'm only 19 years old, but, you know, when people see you doing the right thing, they want to follow you. So I've been focusing on that. So those guys have rallied behind me this week, and they're supporting me, you know, as we go out throughout this stage of not having our starting quarterback. You know, they're helping me, they're lifting me up, giving me confidence and things of that nature, and that means a lot to me that they trust in me that I can go out there and get the job done.
All right, our last one will be for Jordan Hill.
Well, I know they like to play a lot of man. They like to get hands on the outside, and they'll send pressure with it. So we have to do a great job at receiver, getting our hands up, and not allowing the DBs to grab and things of that nature. And up front, we need to do a great job communicating, picking up the blitzes and things like that. It's going to take a team effort for our passing attack to be great this game. But I do believe we can take advantage of the one-on-ones that we will get, and I think. As long as we keep putting in the work this week and focusing on winning our one-on-ones and doing our job, we'll be fine.
All right, that will do it for TJ. Thanks, everybody. Thank you, TJ.
Thank you.